What's going on, everybody? My name is Chris, and welcome back to more Let's Play SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom. I love Bikini Bottoms. Excuse me. The last episode, we started going through downtown Bikini Bottom, and we actually made it to a branching path. See, Jellyfish Fields, when we tackle on Jellyfish Fields, it was more of a linear path for the most part. Actually, I think the entire thing was very linear. And this, from this point in the game and on, it actually branches out a little bit. And while this does go to a dead end and you don't come back anyways, it's still not as linear as Jellyfish Fields was. And that's pretty much a lot more like the rest of the game is. I guess the game wanted to keep it simple for the beginning part. Oh boy. I wonder what this place is going to look like. Welp. Looking pretty bad, actually. The Cenital. I don't think we can actually do too much here.
Someone's broken the sea needle.
How dare they?
That's horrible. The sea needle is the cradle of Crochet Corner.
What?
Yes.
Crochet
yes,
Corner. Oh, because it's a sea needle. I get it.
There are tikis and shiny objects just outside the windows.
Bum, bum, bum.
Mr. Krabs, how can you think of money at a time like this?
Easy. I just clear my mind. Money. Now listen here, boy. You know that I'll give you golden spatulas if you bring me shiny objects. But I'm going to sweeten the deal. If you can break all the tikis here at the Sea Needle, I'll give you a bonus golden spatula.
I swear to God, he just hiccuped right there. He's like, if you can bring me...
Why would I want to break the tikis, Mr. Krabs?
Yeah, because shiny objects?
They were laughing at you and calling you funny names.
How dare they're
what
dead.
What kind of funny names?
You know. SpongeBob. Butt pants.
What?
That's not very funny.
That's a freaking terrible name.
No, but they said your mom was ugly.
That's not really funny
ugly?
Either.
All right, Mr. Krabs, break the my shell. You got a deal.
Hey, we did it. Okay, this child right here. I don't really understand who's leaving the child unattended at a place such as this, considering the windows are broken out. And there's gigantic holes all over the place! They just left the child, especially with Mr. Krabs. He doesn't cur. No curs are given. And there we go. So we can actually use this. And yep, your actual goal here. Oh. Oh, nice. We destroyed the 40 tikis, and then the other one just fall to their death. Yay! Render distance becomes a bit weird here. My OCD just really wants me to get all the shiny objects as well. Even though they're kind of useless. Did I destroy? Nope, doesn't look like it. Alright. Nope. I got it! Trust me, guys. Nope. It's weird, because I do hit it, but it kind of bounces me off. It's like you gotta hit it right dab in the middle, otherwise it just bounces you off. Oh, really? The only thing I haven't destroyed is a floating one, which is normally the easiest one to destroy. They're kind of normally off-center, so you can hit them easier. Best way I know to do this, though, is to dangle down without diving, and then right at the last second dive. I know it's kind of hard to watch just by... There we go. Okay, I think... Yeah, I got all of them. Okay, and press quit. It's kind of hard to notice just by watching, but if you play this game, you'll know what I mean by pressing dive. Because you do dive regardless if you do press A or not, but you just dive more when you press A, I suppose. Oh, we didn't want to go this way, actually. Can we go right? I hope we can. Yes, we can. Alright. Can't go left, though. That's a bit of a bother. Bother. That just reminds me of Powerpuff Pals. I miss the Powerpuff Pals. Oh. I remember watching Powerpuff Pals before it got big. I wish Neo still did the Powerpuff Pals. Well, it blew my mind, because Albino Black Sheep, I don't know how many of you know of that website. That was like before YouTube times. But Albino Black Sheep was the place to watch videos and animations and all that. Well, and Newgrounds, but I never really liked Newgrounds. At least when I was a child, because I was too young for it, I guess. It was too raunchy for me at the time, or something like that. Oh yeah, I gotta be careful now because of the explosive tikis. Okay, another floaty one I missed. Oh, there we go. Okay. Yeah, but like on Albino Black Sheep, a rather famous animator was, someone animated Lemon Demon, who was the leader of that band, is actually the same guy who makes Powder Puppet Pals, and I love their music, and I also love Powder Puppet Pals, and I only found out when my best friend told me that, hey, the guy who made Powder Puppet Pals just made a new song. I was like, oh, what's his band? Lemon Demon? Oh my god, that's the best thing ever. Oh my god. And I was like amazed, my mind was blown. Alright, here we go. Let's go this way. Okay, that just leads back out here, the north door. I really like these compass directions, they are really useful. Oh, great! Well then. We're actually getting introduced to an enemy here we have not seen before. And more on this guy later. Well, pretty much he has freaking missiles he shoots at you. But you guys will see what he's like more later. Whoa! I believe this is actually it. I don't think there's a south door, or is this... Yeah, that there's no south door, I don't think. And you shall see why in a bit. In a little baby bit. Uh-huh. There we go. You know what? I don't even care. No Fs are given. Yeah, I really want that shiny object, thank you. There we go. Okay, now stay clear. Stay clear! There we go. I think that's good. I hope. You know, let's take a look. Alright. I think you don't actually want to die, because if you do, I'm pretty sure the Tiki's all respawn. I think. Maybe. Yeah, I don't know. It makes sense, though, since they respawn everywhere else when you die or leave the area. There we go. All we have left is a south door. Can we talk to you again? Did you do it? Oh, no, we did not. Alright, so let's go over here. Oh no, there's a gigantic freaking hole on this side as well. So the gigantic hole's on both sides, so like, what do you have to do? Well, there's a bus stop here, which is weird. A bus stop on top of the space, or... Sorry, wait, what is this called? The sea needle. I was like, okay, what the heck could Patrick do? What? It's Sandy! Which is really weird, and that you could play as her. She does have a proper introduction.
Oh, hey there, Sandy.
Hi.
Good morning to you, Mr. Krabs.
So, Sandy is... SpongeBob's my second favorite playable character. Sandy is definitely my favorite. Why? She has a double jump plus her third. She has a triple jump, which is actually a hover. How fantastic is that? Fantastic. Her main attack ability of attacking is a karate chop, and she can like do karate kicks in the air. It's fantastic. She can't do any like smashes like Patrick can. She doesn't have an up strike. But let's be honest, she makes up for it for having the ability to hover. She hovers for freaking god dang sakes. Although, can I not do anything here yet? I thought you could. You might have to destroy all the enemies, actually. That might be what it is. Let's try that. I'm pretty sure something spawns if you do that. Oh, my nose is itchy. Oh, there we go. I'm a scratch-aholic. No! That might have been my worst mistake yet, actually. Did the Tiki's respawn? I might have to even just play a SpongeBob to even see that. Oh, great. See, these guys are really obnoxious. Ah, that's actually super annoying. Ah, I might have to redo all of that, come to think of it. I'm not entirely sure. Maybe... Destroy anything? I'm not entirely sure. I know there's a way to get around here. Maybe it doesn't come till later, but I mean, it wouldn't really make too much sense that wouldn't show up now. I'm trying destroying all the enemies and seeing if that does anything for me. Okay, you know what? I think we actually can't complete this place yet. Which is kind of a bummer, because it feels like I just wasted 10 minutes of everybody's time. Well, at least we learned we could play as Sandy. We're gonna go back to playing as SpongeBob now. I don't think we're actually supposed to be in this area, which sucks! Because we can't open the south door because there's a whole gigantic freaking hole there! Although I was pretty sure there was no south window to jump out of. Because the entire freaking place is a gigantic hole! I don't know, maybe there is a ledge though or something. But that was a big waste of time. We're gonna have to go through that again eventually. Ugh. God dang it. I don't even know if I should even bother showing any of that. Oh well, I probably will. Okay, well, anyways, what we really want to do here is you see the gigantic hole over there. And it's like, oh, well, let's just jump through. Well, we actually can't jump through. We have to go through as a ball! normal, and don't even bother trying it as normal SpongeBob because you can. Don't even bother killing those guys either because by the time you get back here, grab the ball and get back over here, they do respawn more. Get out of my way, little puppy dogs. Oh, these guys might be called chompers, actually, or something like that. Oh, he's totally getting in my way! No, he's not. Yes, yes, yes! Yeah, I was gonna say, that better get me through. That was, like, the best shot I could have. If I can destroy this, that's actually close enough. Oh, I thought I was gonna actually blow this up, but no, it blows that gate up. Alright, I'll take it! Oh, is there anything worth getting up there? Well, why not? I'm up to that challenge, are you? No, because you're a freaking scrub! Oh, I went there. Hey! Hi. Don't look so sad, Gary. You sound so sad all the time.
I have been working out.
What?
Meow. Not done. Doesn't that mean...
Meow.
Meow.
Oh, that's the entrance to the rooftops which leads to the lighthouse?
Oh!
There's another golden spatula. I could really use that.
Yeah. Meow. For cooking all those golden burgers and... etc.
What do you mean, get Sandy to help me? I can get through this.
So this is supposed to be the actual introduction of Sandy.
Oh, that gap looks big.
That's what she said.
I'm definitely not making that jump.
And this is where the hover comes in.
Going to get across there.
But we haven't seen that yet.
More robots.
Yes, more robots, SpongeBob.
That gap looks impossible. And impassable.
Oh no, impossible.
Okay, I'll go get Sandy to help me out.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Okay. So we'll open that box. We can't use it yet, but we'll open it for later usage. I believe that's it. Besides, like, you know, all the Sandy stuff, obviously. But for at least the bottom part of Springfield. What? Sorry. Not Springfield at all. But Bikini Bottom. There we go. And this leads... This is where that thing was shooting chairs and sinks at us, and there's the car that the gigantic gap is over there. See that? Yeah. We can go over here as well. Oh, did I want to do that? Hopefully. It also unlocks this again. So you can see there's a steering wheel up there. Alright. Okay, well, let's go grab Sandy then. As you see, we would actually have to talk to Gary, otherwise this stuff doesn't rise and you can't get up here. Right, swap to Sandy. Actually, out of curiosity, what does the sign say when we're not playing as Sandy? Does it say anything funny? You know, sometimes the signs will say something funny if you don't play as a character they're meant for. Jump to the top of these steps. Sandy could glide across the gap, next rooftop by pressing A. Yep. Indeed she can. Although, is there anything I want to do first? See, this is where the part of the level becomes really, well, not really complicated, but it becomes really, like, open to you. Because before it wasn't really too open. See, that's the only thing that sucks about that. Another way to go back. Oh, maybe not. Nope. I can't grab that, apparently. Yeah, the level comes super open to you because now you can go on the rooftop and you can pretty much jump to anywhere you want. Which, finding like all the steering wheels and all that can definitely be more difficult. Ooh, I bet there's something on that rooftop. Standing on the rooftops, everybody scream your heart out. Okay, or it's not anything special at all. Let's jump here.
Better make good use of all these.
Okay. Let's go back here. Oh god dang it! Ah! My thumb stopped. Wait, can I actually make it? No, I don't think I made it up there. I was saying my thumb didn't press down hard enough and I wasn't able to pull up the third hover jump. Since you have to press A 3 times to be able to activate your hover. Which is weird. Well, not really. Actually, it would have been nice if they put it to X or something, since X or Y don't do anything for Sandy. Because you could imagine, like, AAX, but I guess to keep it simple, they do it AAA instead. Alright, let's go over here. Would there be any... Well, I guess we can do this. We go over here, and... the best way for Sandy to take care of these... Oh, okay. Is to actually press... Oh yeah, X does do something for Sandy, that's right. Alright, and that opens this all up. Yeah, we might as well grab this underpants while we're here. Underpants!
Ooh. I'm wearing SpongeBob's underwear.
Yes, you're wearing SpongeBob's underwear. Deal with it, bro. Hopefully this doesn't blow this up. Okay, no, there we go. Alright, This is what I was talking about before, that we couldn't reach this area quite yet. Because now we can with Sandy. And there we go, another golden sock. A golden sock. Yeah, they're not really gold. They're not too gold. They have a gold aura to them, I suppose, but they're not gold themselves. Alright, let's go back to where we were. Which is gonna be annoying, go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Okay, so here we are. Is there anything up on this rooftop? I don't know, there's some of those, but nothing really too special. Alright. So we're just gonna spend the next little bit actually just going from rooftop to rooftop. Holy crap, I almost didn't press A again. Woo! That would have sucked. Go all the way back because I freaking forgot to press A a third time. Is there anything anywhere else we could go to from here? I guess if those tikis did blow up, we could have gotten to there from here as well. They do get really sneaky with the sock placement in this level, though. Which is weird, because this is only the second, like, chronological level in the game. Whoa! That didn't just throw me off, did it? Okay, no, it didn't. Thankfully. That would have sucked. Alright, so yes. You can destroy tikis with karate chop! Monster combo. There we go. Alright, so we do know what that sign says. Whoa! Sandy could lasso by pressing X. That's right, Sandy does actually have an X move. Which, when it targets something, you can press X, and she lassos it. So, yeah, that's really about as much as that. You can use that on enemies. Oh, oh yeah, and then she also has the X move for this, where X on that, and then you glide across it. I feel like they could not think of any way to possibly do these jumps, because look at that. That just looks so out of place, doesn't it? A floating Texas symbol. Okay, then. Oh god! Oh jeez! Yeah, I should have probably thought that through a bit more. Ah, and I have to go all the way back again. Yeah, because the only way to the rooftop is that unless we could, like, somehow. Where was that Texas? Texas? Guys, better be thankful I'm cutting all this stupid falling. I could be one of those asshole Let's Players that don't cut out their failures and they just show the same thing over and over again. Oh god, that'd be terrible. Oh, why am I doing this a second time? This didn't go well the first time. Why am I trying to get... okay, let's go up here. You know what? I really want to kill you. You deserve it. There we go. Okay. There we go up here. And then we go... You. sorry. I definitely think there's... Oh, ooh, maybe there's not anything up here. Nope, there doesn't seem to be. Oh, there's nothing. Or is there? Okay, maybe not. That was worth a look-see. Alright, but we can't. It looks like we get up here from here, which is cool. It's like, look at that. It's like, you know, not really game-breaking stuff, but it's like interestingly cool stuff. Oh, I gotta end up this episode. I gotta finish exploring. I believe. Oh, you know what? The bank is a place we do want to go. Why'd you respond? Where would be the best place to go? Would it be... I think it might be from over here. Or would it be... You know what? No, it wouldn't be. Alright, I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm freaking doing, guys. Ooh. What would be the best... you know what? Let's open up the box, at least, and then come back. Open the box, get on the floor. Everybody walk the box is sore. So what would be the best way at approaching this? I kind of remember, in the video I actually watched of the guy doing the golden spatulas, he went from one of these. But I almost feel like it would, well, at least let's try something, because seriously, it's better than waiting around. I think the guy, the video I watched, the guy made it to there from this one, maybe? This is not gonna work out. At least we have the box open to us now. And, oh, never mind. That's fine. Oh, what was I worried about? I'm a little baby. Okay, and is there anything over here? I could have sworn there's some on the bank. Really? There's nothing here? Well, behind the bank. Nope. Doesn't appear to be. There's seriously nothing on the bank? That's weird. I definitely remember there being someone here. Oh, I still feel pretty cool for being on top of a freaking bank. Alright. Well, let's go back to the box then. Alright. Sorry, teleportation! Unexplained teleportation? I don't even freaking know. Alright, so I think we can make it do that from here. Seriously, it's super overpowered how far you can go with this. Like, look at that! We made it to this exact point from all the way where that box is. Is that not insane? I really gotta stop underestimating that, because that is insane. How many socks do we have? We have 4 out of 9. I feel like I should watch the video one more time to make sure I'm not missing anything. Can we make it to here? From here, rather. Not from there to here. Nothing down there. Alright, well, I definitely want to check that before anyways. Nope. I try my best. Alright, okay, so we're going to get this golden spatula, call it an episode, and if I did miss anything, I'll probably have it at the beginning of the next episode. If not, then we'll just continue on into the lighthouse here. That's what you call it. This doesn't look like a lighthouse at all, though. Well, whatever. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this episode, please leave a like somewhere already. My name's Chris, and I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.